was born on August 15th at 5:20 a.m. Having been born on the same day as my grandmother, she was pretty excited. Although I had been born at such an early time, I'd never really been a morning person. Always wanting to be on my own, it seemed like I was always getting into some kind of trouble. But because of this, I would usually end up getting hurt. Coming to the U.S. from Vietnam at such a young age, my mom was determined to live her best life. From being a model and an actress to skydiving nearly every weekend, she had always told me to never fear what's to come, but to embrace it. I've grown up with the mindset that pain is only temporary, whether that be physically or mentally, which I guess explains why I was never afraid of climbing up trees. You wouldn't guess it from these baby pictures, but I can easily say without a doubt that my mom is my best friend. We joke and rant to each other like we're sisters, being able to talk about anything and everything with each other. But before I was born, my parents had gotten married and planned to start a family. My older brother was born on March 24th, 1996. Ironically, the Breakfast Club was a family favorite. I must admit, my brother was a cute baby, but he was a handful based on our dad's facial expression. I guess I was too. Although my brother is 4 years older than me, we were like two peas in a pod, being inseparable from the day that we met. When my parents had gotten a divorce just 2 years after I was born, my brother and I became closer than ever. Having to do everything together, we argued and wrestled until one of us tapped out. I never tapped out, so he fractured my pinky. My brother has taught me to always stand up for myself, whether it be against him or a stranger. He taught me how to compete and to not take life so seriously. Because of my brother, I had been exposed to lacrosse since the third grade, and I finally worked up the courage to start playing in middle school. It was the best decision I had ever made. If it weren't for lacrosse, I wouldn't have met so many great people who motivated me to push my limits every single day, on and off the field. I began playing in club teams over the summer, being fortunate enough to travel with them. I could not be more thankful to have had the opportunity to meet even more amazing people. Being my favorite high school memory, playing lacrosse had forced me to come out of my shell and enjoy new friendships. Around fall of junior year, I had made the decision to quit playing lacrosse and find a job. This was a very difficult time for me, but I knew it was for the best. I had found a job at Chick-fil-A working 8-hour shifts and even asked if anyone needed their shift covered. Because I worked so often, I've become very close to my coworkers. Although some friendships didn't last, I'm very thankful for them to have been a part of my life. And even more thankful for the people who are in my life today. My grandma has played a huge role in my life, having taught me to always smile even in the worst of times. Unfortunately, she had passed January of this year. Although I was in a bad place, the people in my life were always there to make me smile.
Lauren!
She is brave, generous, and very outspoken, some of the many things I admire so much about her. Throughout the course of our friendship, I've learned to always speak my mind. I always thought Spencer was one of those cool kids that I could have never worked up the courage to talk to. But in time, I learned that he was goofy, loud, obnoxious, and is always dancing. Animated personality makes it difficult to be in a bad mood whenever you're around him. Not caring about what others think, he taught me to never be ashamed of who I am. I can't emphasize how grateful I am to be surrounded by such a caring, accepting, and a hilarious group of people. With my mom's passion for animals and having grown up with a house full of pets, There was no doubt in my mind that I would ever want to live a boring life without a dog, cat, or a bird running around. During my internship at South Coast Pet Hospital, I had accepted a job offer to come back and work over the summer. In the fall, I will be attending OCC to save up in hopes of transferring to either UC Davis or UCI. Although in the future, I'm not too sure if I would want to continue down the path of being a veterinarian, I know I will always be surrounded by animals.